what does Amazon pulling out of New York City mean for jobs?
Yeah, so it's a complicated story. I think on the one hand, in the short term, you know, everybody's nervous when a big tech employer moves into town. I was a recruiter in 2005 when Google moved into town and announced they were hiring 1,500 engineers, and kind of sucked a lot of the oxygen out of the room because they could offer higher salaries and it was kind of the new kid in town. And so in the short term, it creates a lot of competition, a lot of stress on companies who are themselves trying to get really great at hiring and compete for talent. But of course, over the long term, you need employers in a town in order to have it be a vibrant ecosystem. And so, you know, I hope that New York continues to be able to attract great technology companies as it has over the last several decades, and that this isn't the start of maybe a trend.
Well, let's talk about that. You know, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez just tweeting, anything is possible. Today was the day a group of dedicated, everyday New Yorkers and their neighbors defeated Amazon's corporate greed, its worker exploitation, and the power of the richest man in the world. Do you see worker exploitation happening here?
Well, they didn't say a lot of what the employee base was going to be here in New York. And I know that there's been a lot of criticism of Amazon's hiring and employment practices, particularly in its warehouse and distribution locations, and many of those might be well-founded. So there's a whole kind of political angle to it. You know, I tend to think about things through the lens of the talent market, and particularly the technology talent market. And from that perspective, you know, New York has always been home to lots of great companies, but only in the last couple decades, and certainly since the 2007-2008 financial crash, has the rise of technology companies played such a big role in the economy here as compared to, you know, it used to be historically a Wall Street town. And so now, for, you know, today's technology worker, you want to have large employers working on challenging problems in technology. You need those big companies, and there's a growing vibrant base of kind of VC-backed and high-growth tech companies here in New York, but you always want a couple of those bigger anchor organizations around as well to provide, you know, growth opportunities and kind of to have experienced managers to draw from and all these other things that are a part of the ecosystem.
Congresswoman Carolyn Maloney of New York, we're continuing to get reaction from lawmakers here. She put out a statement saying, disappointed that New York City won't be home to 25,000 new jobs from HQ2 and that Long Island City will lose out on infrastructure improvements that would have accompanied this project. This is not the Valentine that New York needed. Of course, today is Valentine's Day, Daniel. New York is home to a lot of giant corporations, a lot of giant tech companies. Amazon already has 5,000 workers there. Google has a big presence in New York City. Quickly, we have about a minute left here. Does this hurt New York City? How much does this really hurt jobs in New York City?
Yeah, I don't know how much like tech, you know, infrastructure investment it was actually going to drive. I mean, New York is a city that's very big, and so the addition of one employer, even a big one, isn't going to make or break this great city. But look, you know, especially in Long Island City, where they have to take trains and things in and out of the borough, you do put a big strain on the aging subways and other transportation platforms. So I think as a New Yorker for almost 25 years, we need more infrastructure regardless. But I don't think this is gonna destroy or impact overall the economy here in New York. We're a big town; we can handle it. And there's lots of good employers that'll be here now and later.